this giraffe that's decided to come up and have a drink. He's over there. He, of course, has got to be very, very careful about having a drink, because he's got to open his legs up, splay them apart, put his head down, and when he's down like that, he is massively vulnerable to the attentions of lions and hyenas. I say he, but I do mean she in her particular case. Walking very slowly to the water. It's been a very Sunday afternoon-y here at this waterhole. We haven't done a huge amount of moving around, and everything's just kind of come this way, which has been rather splendid. Now I'm just going to put my jersey on because it's getting a bit cold, but David of course will suffer through the cold because he must bring you pictures, unfettered access to this beautiful giraffe cow. I think we're just going to sit here, if it's all the same to you everyone, simply because she's coming to have a drink, and if we start moving around I think she will be distracted and perhaps not come down. Just to give you an update, apparently those lions have been found, and Byron is waiting to sort of get into the sighting. So you should be seeing lions fairly soon. There she comes. And look at the colours. Sorry, yes. David very cleverly pointed out that I left my busby inside my shirt, and therefore I became inaudible briefly. Hold on. Look at the colours there of her, juxtaposed with the reds and oranges and golds and browns of the trees behind. I think that's stunning. In the background you can hear I've only just realised this, that's a Shelley's Franklin calling. Come on, old girl. That's it. No, don't stop. Keep going. She's thinking, oh, I don't know about this. There's just a bit too much activity around here. There are large, strange birds around that aren't here normally. There's a car parked. I'm on camera. Don't know if I want to drink anymore. Looking at the wildebeest off behind. Oxpecker tickling away at her neck, considering all her options. And I'm being slightly facetious, of course, but this is what they do all the time. You've got to be very careful. She'll be checking every bush to see if there isn't a lion lying in wait to devour her when she spreads her front legs apart to bend over and have a drink. It's not that usual that we get to see this kind of thing, so I think it's worth just sitting for a little while longer. There's another one coming. There are another two coming. Oh, it's all happening here. Of course, Dave, every time I point at something in a different direction is to re-level the camera. That's why the horizon tilts slightly, like you're on a boat every so often. Moving painstakingly closer to the water. Come on, brave lady. There's the Shelley's Franklin calling. Yes, we are standing here. We have not moved. Oh, they're so gracefully making their way across the clearing. The other two and this one now thinking. They always seem to get into this drinking mode where they duck their heads a bit, then lift them up again and stand and look ponderous about the place. Duck their head half a little bit, back up again. I'm going to decide if it's actually worth having a drink or not. And they're not particularly water dependent, so they don't have to drink. But if they can, they will. Oh, look at that. Three of them. Here we are. A great journey of giraffe. There's another one in the background. They're way away there. Dark, dark one. There you are. Left a bit. That's it. They're all coming. There seems to be some kind of a Sunday evening giraffe conference here. That's a big bull. He's the second bull. Now they will probably be in communication. We can't hear it. There's the first bull. The others are cows. You'll probably be in communication with all of them. They talk with, or talk, I mean they communicate with a very low rumbling infrasound, which we are unable to hear with our fairly unsophisticated ears. Look how the male is a lot less cautious than the females. A lot less considerate of the dangers that might be here. He's just thinking about getting to the pub with the girls. See that, David? That'd be a lesson to you. Mm-hmm. Ill-considered drinks at pubs with girls can lead to trouble. He doesn't think much of that advice at all. He's fantastic. Wonderful. And now they're all standing going, I wonder what we should do now. I don't know what she thinks she's doing. If there's some kind of communication going on here, if she's looking for lions or cheetahs, I've got no idea. Thinking maybe there's a crocodile in here, keeping an eye out for that. The oxpeckers are all going. That's sometimes an alarm call from them. They don't seem to be alarmed at all, though. Sorry about the aerial, everybody. We just have to have it up, otherwise, we can't hear the final control talk to us. Yeah, he's definitely far less worried about what might be at the water. He's a young male. You can see he's shorter than she is. Hello, Alec. I think Alec or Alice in Ohio, you want to know about whether giraffes are waders. Do they ever go into the water? And it's Alice, not Alec. Alice, you... Sorry, Alice. I completely misheard your name. Communications from the final control, utterly horrendous this afternoon. So, Alice, you want to know if giraffe ever wade into the water? No, giraffe are not waders. Again, they would be far too vulnerable. I mean, I imagine they've crossed rivers before and gone into water every so often, but they don't by default wade in the same way that elephants do. Thank you for your question, Alice. I shall now remember it. Your name, I mean. I will almost certainly forget your question, because that is that's the price you pay for being the age I am. This is a wonderful picture, even if it is, ooh, frisky young male. No, we're not going to have a drink. We've decided against it. Let's go and ask the old boy. Now, there's a wonderful shot. Look at that. So the big male there, that is second from the left, he is probably, I'd say, about, almost 20 years old. He's much darker than the others. He's lost the end of his tail. He's clearly much more experienced than the other male because his horns are bald on top almost.
and he's got that median horn, he's got that very sort of heavy calcification of the skull, and the young male doesn't have that. You can hear the Senegal lapwing going, now Susan, you're very astutely asking what subspecies of giraffe we're looking at here. It's a subspecies called the southern giraffe. There are 9, according to some. Some say 11, some say 7 subspecies of giraffe. This particular one is called the southern giraffe. And while we wait and see if they actually come down and drink, or if they're just going to prevaricate all afternoon long. Prevaricate is a very good word, David.
Thank you,
John. You may use it. Not sure what it means either. There are all the pictures of the different subspecies of giraffe that you get here, or not here. So we get the southern giraffe, and the only one which is, I can't even tell which one it is. Hang on one sec, everyone. There, it's that one, right at the bottom. Angolensis, the southern giraffe. And look at all the other amazing variations that occur throughout Africa. There are about, well, like I say, many. You just count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. He's got 12 here, but that will be disputed by some people. Marvellous. Now, here they come to have a little bit of a, maybe a drink. I've been saying that many times, haven't I? But they keep prevaricating, David. Mitch, lovely question from you and well noticed. You say giraffe, rather like hyena, walk with one leg, or at least with both legs on each side. So that's completely different from a dog or from a horse or from an impala that will walk left front, right back, right front, left back. They walk left front, left back, right front, right back. You see what Mitch means from New York. Thank you, Mitch, for that. I mean, this is fantastic. Look at the picture of them there. So you want to know if they run like that. No, they don't. They run in a sort of canter. And a canter is that sort of 3-beat movement, exactly the same as a horse. And what it is if you're going to, you know, just listen carefully now, because it can get a little confusing. A 3-beat canter, everybody, basically constitutes back right leg, okay, starting the movement, then left back and left front touching, at least left back and right front touching the ground in diagonals, and then leading the last foot to land would be the left front foot. And that's basically what a canter is. And they do, that's how they run. So it's not the sort of, it's not just a faster version of their walk, if you know what I mean. This is fantastic. Look at this. Hello, B. Ellie the Backpacker. Another nice question from you. Thank you for it. You say, did giraffe live alone? B. Ellie the Backpacker, giraffe do not live alone always. They can, though. Like you say, you've seen them living alone before with us, and they certainly can live alone, B. Ellie the Backpacker, but they don't always. They are sometimes in these groups, and they're often in these groups, not permanently. So that's sort of a loose association that they have here. And the female's much more likely to be together than the males. This is an unbelievable sighting. And Deborah Armchair Traveller, good question. You say, do I think that giraffe communicate with elephants with that low frequency rumbling? No. Deborah, I'm almost certain that they don't. I'm almost certain that that low frequency rumbling is an entirely, single specific noise that they make. So I don't think that they'll hear it If an elephant calls, they might hear if an elephant calls. I won't know what it means, though. So it's just a tone. It's not the actual... I hesitate to use the term words, but it isn't the actual words that they're hearing. It would just be the sound. This is just fantastic. I really do feel rather privileged to be witnessing this lot. And Tasha, you say, do they have a leader? No, absolutely not, they don't. I think giraffe dominance and the like is decided by size almost exclusively. And that's certainly the case with the males. And I don't imagine there's any kind of hierarchy amongst the females at all. Now this chap is thinking about having a drink. Look at this, isn't that wonderful with their reflections? I think that's stunning. Very nice, David. A giraffe ideal for an imbecile photographer like myself because they move so very slowly. The colour around us is just incredible. It's like an orange glow has enveloped us, and these giraffes are, well, they're covered in the same sort of orange, aren't they? And you saw those pictures of the different giraffe. Now, these chaps, if you saw these chaps together and you didn't know any better, you'd say, oh, well, they definitely belong to a different subspecies from each other because they're all different colours. And this is why it gets so difficult to decide how many subspecies there genuinely are. Wonderful stuff. Now, Julianne, very astute question, which I possibly should have given you the answer to before you even asked it. You said, do the subspecies live together? No, Julianne, they don't live together. They live on their own, and they're separated by geography, and that's, in fact, probably why they've evolved to be slightly different subspecies. They would have all been the same at one stage. Very nicely thought out. So you can almost completely show what the subspecies is from where they occur. All right, let's go back across to our old pal Byron, find out if he's been enjoying his afternoon off, and maybe he's got some lions, but he'll tell you if and when you're going to see them. The endless waiting game of seeing if a giraffe will drink continues here, everybody, at the Cheetah Plains Pan, and we've been let down again. There she goes. All right, I'm going to leave these giraffes. Therefore, you are too. We're going to pop gently down into the clearings very quickly. Oh, are we? Oh, here we go. You're not going to be able to reach the water from there. I'm pretty sure you're wasting your time. Yeah, Monique, I think you're absolutely correct. You say that perhaps the waterhole edge is too high and they're afraid, you know, that they might slip. Yeah. I think that's absolutely correct. And if they do slip, a giraffe will really struggle to get up. If this giraffe was to fall into this water, you'd be almost certain that it would die here. It happened fairly recently with our friends the Matimba males. A giraffe died in a pan because he slipped into it and he just couldn't get up. And eventually those two lions leapt on him and they fed on him for many days. I also think she's being slightly distracted by us, and so let's just move off, because if she really does want to drink, I don't want to stop her doing it.